second hot copy, a food firm is trying to spread joy amid these trying times. It's called the HapPinas Project. And we have with us this morning Kristine Go. She's the Vice President for Food and Refreshments of Unilever Philippines. Kristine, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. I like the name already because there's some happiness in the name. So what's HapPinas? What is it all about?
So actually, HapPinas started last year, you know, when COVID actually hit the country. Mm-hmm. I think it was really a very difficult time for a lot of people. You know, our economy crashed. A lot of people were isolated with the lockdowns. There was hardly any mobility. And I think what we found out was that people's happiness was at an all-time low. We went from being the 52nd happy country in the world to actually the 61st. So that's 9 points down. And I think one of the things that that we did was we partnered with the United Nations to actually conduct a survey. And the survey said that 66% of Filipinos said that more than money and career success, it's actually human connections that makes them happy. And really, happiness is all about us wanting to bring happiness back to the Philippines.
Mm-mm. And so you essentially said that because of the happiness index of Filipinos, would you say this was one of the inspirations why you started HapPinas?
It was. In fact, you know, as you said, the word happiness was actually coined out of two root words, you know, happiness and Pilipinas. And what we really wanted to do was to, you know, make happiness something that's ownable for the Philippines. We wanted to get people to connect again. And really to, you know, drive these human connections together. And we wanted to tell people that, you know, just because they are physically distant doesn't mean that they need to be socially apart.
But what is the campaign all about? I mean, clearly the idea is there, the vision is there, but is this incorporated in your products or is this a CSR?
It is incorporated in our products. Partly, it is also CSR. Okay. I think at the root of it, we know that nothing brings a smile to people's faces more than ice cream. Mm-hmm. And the whole program is the whole campaign is really there to encourage people to actually connect again and gift ice cream to their families, mm-hmm. their friends, to all their loved ones. Mm-hmm. And we always feel that, you know, as I said, nothing brings a smile to people's faces more than ice cream. Mm-hmm. So for every purchase of ice cream, for every, you know, happy moment that is posted online, we actually put a pin in what we call our happiness map. Oh. The map is a symbol that, you know, though we are apart, we don't have to be, you know, really distant. Mm-hmm. The whole program actually connects every single person in the Philippines. I can imagine, you know, giving ice cream to my parents in Davao. And even my parents-in-law in Cebu. And that's something that I can do very, very easily.
Oh, so how do people participate? I'm curious. So let's say I bought ice cream. I went to the grocery, bought ice cream. How do you measure? What do I do? I post it. And what do you tag? What do you do?
So on one hand, the purchase itself is actually counted as a pin because that's your happiness. At the same time, you know, when you post it, when you send it to someone, the person who actually receives it is also, you know, another pin on the map.
How do you measure the pin? So what's the importance of the pin to the consumer?
The pin is actually, so on one hand, you have the pin, which is actually important for you as well as for the person that you're giving. But at the same time, every single pin that we have on the map is actually an ice cream that we give to a community in need. Yo. So that's, you know, another big kind of like, you know, bonus of the whole campaign.
Okay, so let me understand it. So let's say I bought ice cream or 20 people bought ice cream. How much or how many do you give in a community?
For every scoop of ice cream that actually gets bought, that's one more person that we give an ice cream to.
So
imagine for free.
And where do you give them?
We actually have identified communities in the Philippines with our NGO partners. Mm-hmm. So we are partnered with Kawad Kalinga, we are partnered with Project Pearls. And these companies, these communities, which actually they've identified, they're the ones who will be recipients of our ice creams as well. Mm-hmm. Plus, because we have partnered very strongly with our retailers, mm-hmm. our big supermarket chains, our convenience store chains, plus even our delivery apps, right? The communities and the kind of like the foundations that they want to support, yeah. they are also recipients of, you know, our ice cream.
Uh-oh. And are you giving in Metro Manila? Because I can just imagine with the two-week ECQ, some people need your happiness right now.
We are.
They're already feeling it with the first
yes.
day.
And not just in Metro Manila, in a lot of different places all over the Philippines, because we know that, you know, lockdowns are not only here, they are all over, everywhere from the south, you know, from Mindanao to Visayas to everywhere in the north. You know, I think a lot of people really do need some happiness right now.
Oh, so what is the goal? I mean, one is, of course, you want more people happy, but what's the overall goal of the campaign in terms of the number of ice creams that you want to give out and I guess also want to sell?
So last year, believe it or not, I think with all of the actions that we were doing with frontliners, we managed to actually hit about 650 million happy moments. This year, because it
like
is
650
also,
million ice cream.
Last year. Oh. Yeah,
wow.
That's last year. But this year, we want to do even more. This year, we wanted to hit 700 million happy moments.
Uh-oh.
And really bring the Philippines, you know, back on the map as one of the happiest countries in the world.
And how do you measure ice cream bought? Is it, don't get me wrong, because I eat ice cream, are the point system of, let's say, one stick of ice cream the same as 1 gallon of ice cream?
No, it is not. It is obviously a gallon of ice cream, which can serve, you know, more people the family, has more points, yes.
Uh-uh, uh-uh.
And more than that, actually, even the social media post that people do, so, you know, when they post any happy moment that they have, and they actually tag us with the hashtag share happiness,
uh-oh.
It actually also gets counted into the happiness map.
Uh-oh. But then other than the map, does a person who posts a really good photo, a touching photo, do they win something?
Well, I'd like to think that they actually... that they actually win happiness back, which is always a great thing.
Yeah.
And
a few calories.
Measures.
And a few
yes.
calories too.
yes, a few.
Okay, I'm curious. I mean, just while we're talking about ice cream anyway, and I just have to include health in this situation. Is Selecta moving on towards options for healthier ice cream?
Of course. In fact, I think one of the things that we believe in is that obviously there is a place for an occasional treat like ice cream mm-hmm. within a balanced diet and an active mm-hmm. lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
But that being said, we also make sure that the formulation of our ice cream and everything that we market follows a certain, you know, nutritional standards.
Mm-hmm.
So we've set limits on sugar as well as calories.
Mm-hmm.
And we've also made sure that it is transparent in all of our packaging so that consumers
uh-oh.
Who actually buy an ice cream make a conscious decision mm-hmm. on their consumption based on their diet.
And are you going to move to a dairy-free, sugar-free ice cream? I can imagine it'll be expensive though. I mean,
we already have it with Magnum. Magnum actually has a dairy-free
yeah.
alternative.
Yeah.
It has done so well
yes.
and it's really delicious. I think the secret to making sure that things are healthy is that you still make it delicious. So I hope you get to try it.
Yeah, I did. I did. But is that part of the happiness spins? That's part
it
of
is. It is.
Okay.
Yes.
So any ice cream bought is the happiness. Okay, what's next after this July's International Ice Cream Day? Who knew there was an International Ice Cream Day? It's the
yes.
first time I'm hearing it from you guys. This
yes.
is good.
No, so I think that the happiness campaign, which we started in, you know, International Ice Cream Day, is not something that we wanted to just stay within a day or stay within a month. Mm. We wanted it to be something that is really, you know, I guess impactful the whole year round. Mm. So while, you know, we just launched this right now, we are going to be counting all of the happy moments, all of the ice cream purchases throughout the year and even up to next year. And it's really something that we wanted to be able to scale, you know, year on year.
All right. Well, on that note, Kristine, I have to say, it's quite refreshing to see that in the midst of the pandemic, here's Unilever. You're quite aggressive, just making sure to come up with new campaigns, new products. And I think the country, I mean, the market needs it as well. Anything you'd like to add, Kristine?
I guess maybe just to close, I go back to what I said earlier about, you know, while the pandemic may have kept us physically apart, we'd like to remind everyone that just because we are physically distant doesn't mean that we can't maintain social connections, mm-hmm. especially if we share happiness with a Selecta ice cream with someone. So I hope you join us. And I'd really like to take this opportunity to invite everyone to actually spread more happiness within the Philippines through happiness.
All right, Kristine Go, thank you so much for being on.
Thank you, Karen.